One of our main goals at Lansdowne Crescent is to have our students leave our school with really embedded 21st century citizen skills. We want them to be collaborative, creative, and have really highly developed problem solving skills. So we know that one of the best ways for them to be able to do that is through a really rich curriculum that is very hands-on and active and presents them with problems and real-life learning situations. Science is an amazing vehicle for that. We teach science really explicitly and proactively from kindergarten right through to grade six. And our teachers are becoming increasingly skilled and confident in teaching science and teaching in a very hands-on way.
It hasn't really gone up much,
yeah,
has it?
About 3 degrees maybe.
Yeah.
I think it's because the sun's behind a cloud mainly.
I don't think that's on. It should get some more sun in there. So maybe we could use some books to, or something to put under it so it will get the right angle.
We've got a beautiful environment here that we can get them out into to really put the things that they're learning in the classroom into practice in the big wide world. So we're very connected to our local environment, the Knocklofty Reserve, and we like to use that environment to learn from but also to be able to teach others about.
This is the frog ponds, and as you can see, there's not much water there at the moment. As you can see on the iPad, there's actually a picture of what it looks like in winter. So if you come and have a look here. And if you look very carefully over there, you may be able to hear and see maybe a frog.
One of the great aspects of our science program is the involvement of people from outside of the school. We have partnerships with through the Scientists in Schools program, which link us up to scientists from many areas of science that come in and work with the children, or we go out and work with them. One of the great indicators that we have that students are really learning their science is their ability to teach one another what they've learned.
This is the sandstone quarry, and you can see all these stones are discards from buildings. Like this one has, this has 16 written on Roman numerals, XVI. Then the quarry was mined for buildings like cottages and the cathedral.
I've never had a student who wasn't interested in science. They all love participating in it because so much of it's hands-on and so much of it is connected to the real world. They get to answer the questions that they have through doing science. So I really wanted to push my students last year to participate in some science competitions because I thought they would grow through that, and I thought I would as a teacher as well. The students really grew in confidence. We had lots of trips to UTAS that made them feel very special. Of course, their knowledge of scientific method and working scientifically improved as a result of that.
Science is a really strong area of learning in our school. Primary Connections has also been a support for those people who aren't feeling necessarily that confident, but we've also run quite a lot of professional learning for staff around science. Lansdowne Crescent Primary School were successful in a Becoming Asia Literate grant application in 2010, and we became the lead school, and our project was called Unity and Diversity.
We were looking at whether we could see the difference between the silver wattle and the black wattle.
And what is the difference?
You can see the leaves are very similar, so it's a bit hard to check, in particular in dry seasons when they all curled up a bit. So then you have to look at the trunk, and you can see the trunk of the tree over there, fairly smooth and grey.
Our unifiers were biodiversity, because we're all very fortunate. We have beautiful environments that we can just step out into, that intersection of systems and human intervention and issues to do with that, and students perhaps advocating for concerns that they have based on the information that they've gained from their investigation or their research, or and talks from experts and that type of thing.
I'm part of Friends of Knocklofty, and I'm the coordinator. And that group was formed 20 years ago to improve the environment in the Knocklofty Reserve and also liaise with school children and community groups and so on, just to show them the value of having a reserve so close to the city. And we have found that the more that we improve the conditions here, the more people come and participate. And it's lovely to have school children here because they then get a feeling for the environment and they get a kind of proprietary interest when they do planting with us and a bit of weeding and whatever.
We also had Indonesian as our other through line. Children have gone to St. Oklofty and written a reflective piece on how they've enjoyed or learned from that space, and then they've interpreted that and translated that into Indonesian.
Banyak macam binatang terdapat pada Oklofty.
A huge area of fauna has been identified on Oklofty.
Selama 20 tahun terakhir Kelompok Teman Oklofty telah menanam lebih dari 3,000 tanam.
And I think the learning that they've done and the research investigation and the opportunities that the science learning has provided them has really helped their self-esteem and their self-development, and they see themselves now as having a greater set of skills that they can offer. Science is a hugely motivating opportunity, so they see this as being a worthwhile activity, and there's a lovely sort of cooperation between them, and you know, they're investigating, they're getting their tools together, they're talking. Yeah, I think the development of the child is enhanced through their opportunities to play, explore and investigate, predict and question.
So last year I was invited to create a soundscape with a grade 5 class which would link in with the work that the rest of the school were doing in the land to sea biodiversity segment. I took this grade 5, or rather they took me, on a walk up to Oklofty. Of course it's an exceptionally beautiful place, and I thought how we could transfer these things into music, into a soundscape describing the area.
This is the reflection pond. We made a piece of music to go to the reflection ponds. Then we'd have some chimes, we'd have some singing bowls, you know, like you swirl, add some cymbals, and you'd hear people whispering words to describe the ponds, like calm, peaceful. We named it Reflection, so you can reflect your memories while you're listening to the piece.
It's just a lovely recognition that learning for science can be represented in music, it's represented in poetry, it's represented in writing, it can be represented in a finding that the person's got from their investigation. So it's beautiful to involve everybody in that.